In Ornos, only a subset of institutions were chosen to do the georeferencing rather than all of the institutions. And those institutions were chosen based on their previous expertise. So they were the best 7 out of the 20 that worked for Manus. So we picked the best. They were the most efficient in the way they were doing it. That contributed some to the speed. The rest was entirely contributed by an increase in our capabilities using new software that we've developed under the BioGeoMancer project and under the GeoLocate project. So these tools include GADAM, which is a global administrative boundary database. It can, includes spatial data for all the world's administrative boundaries, from the country down to the very smallest. And sometimes, in some cases, in some countries, 5 different levels of administration. GeoLocate worked on in the earlier days, on a desktop georeferencing application, one in which you could enter individual textual descriptions and have the software return the georeference for you. Or you could batch load, that is to say, upload an entire set of locations and have the software return the georeferences for those of one another. BioGeoMancer was an online version of the same. It did much the same thing using much the same algorithms. Then, something that you'll see hopefully tomorrow, the originating tool was used in the very beginning, and that's the Manus georeferencing calculator. This calculator is something that's available in your software folder on your flash drive, and is an applet that allows you to enter all of the sources of uncertainty for a location, as well as the location itself. And the calculator gives you the answer about where the end location is and all of its uncertainties. And I'll show that to you tomorrow, hopefully. This is just a picture showing what the very first version of GADAM provided. You can see in some places, such as Australia, you can actually see the lines depicting the administrative boundaries. Whereas in India, it's so detailed that it all looks white at this scale. There's so many different levels of information in that case. All of them are names. So what it meant was that if you were able to find an administrative boundary such as Karicho in the Rift Valley in Kenya, it could give you a shape for that. And if you have the shape, you could get a georeference automatically, at least to that administrative boundary. Maybe not more specific than that, but at least that much. And all automatically. This is just a screenshot of the early days of GeoLocate, which now has an online version and also has a collaborative platform where you can share your georeferencing project among institutions and collaborate much the way that Manus and Ornos and Hartman did in the early days, but using an online platform. So I urge you to take a look at the website for GeoLocate and its capabilities. Unfortunately, with 2.5 hours, we have no time to use any of these tools. Only time to show you what georeferencing is about and how hard it can be if you have to do it the hard way. Then finally, BioGeoMancer was a program to do all of what I just said online, and is a visual user interface to do georeferencing using the point radius method, using Google Maps as a background. BioGeoMancer at this point in its life is the victim of a bad server crash and is likely to come back to life as soon as I get the free time to deal with it. Right now is not actually online. Coming very soon is the next generation of BioGeoMancer, which is called just GeoMancer. and it doesn't have a user interface. It has an API, that you could call from other programs to do the automated georeferencing. And the things that it does uniquely well are to understand a written descriptive language in the original language in which it was given, and translate that to English if the translation capability exists in Google, which I think at this point has 67 different languages. So it can translate from those languages into English and then interpret it as English to georeference and then give you the end results. It does this using a variety of tools that Google makes available, including predictions, Google Translate, and Google Maps. So that's in the testing phase right now, and will be made publicly available within the next month or two. And then finally, we'll get to the georeferencing calculator. I have just 10 minutes now because I'm not going to go over our promised time. The georeferencing calculator takes the principles of georeferencing and basically walks you through a menu of the things that you need to know in order to get the final answer. So this screenshot shows an early version of the georeferencing calculator in which you choose a locality type, or sorry, a calculation type, one where you want to get coordinates and error in the result. After that, you have a choice of locality types. So something like this one, a distance at a heading from a named place. You have that, and the rest of the calculator shows you fields that you need to fill in order to get the answer. So we'll use this calculator tomorrow. We actually have to do an exercise using it. Before that, you're going to have to get a little bit more background about all the things that this calculator is asking you to answer. And that's something that we're going to have to spend a little bit of time on tomorrow. As I said, georeferencing normally is a five-day workshop. So after tomorrow, when we finish with this, don't expect to be an expert georeferencer. I hope that you will understand that you can't possibly be an expert georeferencer walking out of this room from this workshop, but you'll appreciate some of the things that are